NBA players are also no slouches on their feet. Now, some of the game's biggest names are winding back the clock to ensure they keep themselves in elite shape, opting for a low-carb diet. Kim Brunhuber with that story.
At a camp for hot prospects run by the NBA, over the drumbeat of basketballs, one name kept coming up, LeBron.
That was one of the first things that came up. They're like, have you seen how skinny LeBron got? And then I saw the picture and I was like, whoa.
The picture, LeBron looking not quite skeletal exactly, but substantially reduced, whittled down.
If it works, it may start something new in the NBA.
Other NBA players like Carmelo Anthony have dramatically shed pounds. The explanation? A diet high in fat, low in carbs, to force the body to burn fat as fuel.
They're consuming foods like butter and cheese and cream and olive oil.
For years, nutritional researcher Jeff Volek has been advocating it. Eat fewer carbs and you can access more fuel. Now, more top athletes seem to be listening.
We're going to see, at least in some athletic circles, that this becomes more of a standard and not just a sort of fleeting fad.
Dietitian Nancy Guest worked with Olympic athletes who tried the diet and said they won't ever do it again. She says going low carb is a perfectly good way to achieve a sculpted body in the off season only.
The scientists that feel that we can have this 30-day adaptation to a low carb diet and use fat as a fuel is simply not going to be successful with an athlete that is doing a high intensity sport.
The Winnipeg Jets director of fitness says nutrient dense carbs like rice and pasta will stay on his players' menus.
They're burning a lot of calories, then they require a lot of carbohydrates to have sufficient glycogen stores in their body, and that's what your muscles run on.
He's going to be faster, but he's going to be weaker.
No matter what the trend in the NBA, no low-carb diet for Brandon Bernard.
I'm a pretty skinny kid myself, so I don't think so.
Most experts say a diet that works for elite athletes who are under constant medical supervision may not be appropriate for the rest of us. In other words, if you don't play like LeBron, you probably shouldn't eat like LeBron. Kim Brunhuber, CBC News, Toronto.